Von Fox was a B-17 pilot during World War II who flew a number of missions over Germany. On one such occasion, his fuel tank was hit by an enemy missile and he was forced to land the plane. Miraculously, he survived, and upon which he discovered that the missile had not detonated. If it had, his plane and himself would have exploded immediately. Upon returning to the United States, Fox asked to keep the unexploded missile as a souvenir, a sign of goodwill shown towards him. However, upon further investigation, it was found that not one, but 11 missiles had hit his fuel tank. They were immediately sent off to intelligence for further investigation, where it was revealed that all 11 missiles were empty, save one. The one missile contained a note written in the Czech language that said, "This is all we can do for now." A courageous Czechoslovakian factory worker had disarmed the missiles and written the note. He realized he couldn't end the war, but he could save one plane, and it made a difference. There are fewer stories that better summarize the problem of poverty. It's been an issue, and how to end it has been debated since the beginning of time, and the argument has left many frustrated, discouraged, or cynical. Yet ending poverty begins with a change within ourselves. If we each decided to take action out of a personal conviction, the world that we live in would look drastically different for the better. Today, I will discuss the problem of poverty, the vision I have for a poverty-free world, and some simple steps for action that you can take to be the change that you wish to see in your world. Poverty is generational. It's a cycle. The first step is summarized well in the words of Confucius, where he states, "If your plan is for 1 year, plant rice. If your plan is for 5 years, plant trees. And if your plan is for 100 years, educate your people." The cycle of poverty and educating others about it was first introduced by the New York Times in a fantastic article in 2008, where it outlined that today's youth have the odds stacked against them to obtain an education and therefore hope for a successful future. This is not good. Children are directly affected, leaving future generations in dire circumstances. The Center for Disease Control released in 2009 new research that showed an increase in preventable childhood diseases. These diseases are just that, preventable, yet they're still increasing. Many children receive only one full meal during the school lunch hour, while others have to go hungry during the cafeteria time. The stressors of poverty also negatively affect children's ability to take standardized testing in an article released in Current Issues in Education magazine in 2003. In addition, because of the increased levels of poverty in our nation, many shelters and food pantries are over capacity, as discovered by the Boston Globe in 2011. Michigan Live News in 2010 discovered that the largest homeless shelter in our nation is now having to limit the amount of time a person can stay due to an increase in demand. This is adding to our homeless statistics around the nation, leaving those faced with absolute poverty, unstable housing, and facing eviction few options. The crime rates in our nation have increased as a direct result of poverty increasing as well. According to Patterson, in a study done in 2006, community crime rates have a correlation with absolute poverty, poverty defined as not having the basic necessities to go on with daily life and survive. Heitz and Pugh in 2011 developed further upon that with a meta-analysis study that showed a relationship between homicide, assault, and poverty. Poverty is a rough reality to face, but fortunately, it doesn't have to end there. While it is easy to feel overwhelmed, we need to remember that our actions do make a difference. The key to winning the war is focusing on the individual battles. If we all choose to open our eyes and make a difference, change will happen. By choosing to give financially, volunteer your time, or write a letter to Congress, you are effectively making the statement, "I choose to end poverty." The first action you can take is donating to your local food pantry. This can be with food items or financially. Both are needed. If everyone gave just one food item per week, the national food shortage would be reversed. Volunteer your time to give to shelters, whether that be volunteering at a local soup kitchen serving food, or by changing sheets in a homeless shelter, or delivering meals. By giving your time, you are saying to the people you are serving, you are worth my time, and I choose to put a face on poverty as well. The third thing you can do is write a letter to Congress, urging them to make poverty solution a priority. Why handwritten letters? Simply put, because they work. There's something about the handwritten. According to the Global Poverty Awareness Organization, Bread for the World, 96% of Capitol Hill staff reported in a survey that if their member of Congress had not reached a decision on an issue, handwritten letters would help make a difference. Choosing to take action, even in the smallest of ways, will create immense benefits. By giving financially, volunteering time, or choosing to write a letter to Congress, you are taking a momentous step in creating a poverty-free nation. By donating food, we move one step closer to ending absolute poverty. According to the Bread for the World Institute, in 2011, they outlined their Bread for the World's nutrition program, a program designed to help children learn how to buy, cook, and get the necessary ingredients for good nutrition, and to have then brain power to be able to focus in school and obtain good grades. Additionally, children that have positive role models are much less likely to become involved in crime. This was done with the boys' Hornick and Ogden study in 2010. By writing a letter to Congress, you are putting pressure on those in positions of power to enact change on a magnitude scale. Other communication mediums, such as email, are too large in volume and often pass under the radar. By giving a handwritten letter, it's mandatory that it is read and logged, which guarantees that your voice will be heard. Lastly, by choosing to be involved in ending poverty by participating in one or all of the above-mentioned ways, you yourself will directly experience the benefit. When you choose to reach out of your immediate comfort zone by participating in such programs, you are constantly reminded of how blessed you are. These experiences will help keep your priorities in check, benefiting you and those around you. Second, by taking action, you are actively demonstrating compassion. Compassion, one of the threads that unites all of humanity. And it reminds those who are struggling that they are not alone in life. By choosing to invest, you are effectively saying to those in need, you are worth my time. To give and receive this kind of acknowledgement provides virtue that is difficult to put words to. Today I've discussed the problem of poverty and some simple steps for action that you can take to create a poverty-free nation. You never know when you yourself might be in need one day. Today, over 49 million North Americans are living in poverty as we speak, and we have the chance to be part of the solution. Coming around the room right now is a sheet of paper with some of the web addresses of the organizations you can choose to donate to or be involved with, along with a sample letter to Congress. I urge you to take some time and think about what I've shared with you today. Together, we can make a difference. Like the Czechoslovakian factory worker, we can choose to do something with what we have for the right now.
Thank you very much.
I probably need